有讲有，
无讲无，
卖讲有讲无。Okay, so this is a new series of our Gong Wu Gong Bo. If you think that you have a better name for us, right, please drop a comment. We will seriously consider it, okay?
Yeah, so basically, what we are doing over here is trying to engage with our viewers and our followers, lah. So. Okay?
Okay, so today's topic will be on PLH, the Prime Location Housing. Okay, the very hot topic now, okay?
Yeah, so caveat over here, this is purely our thoughts and our opinions, okay? It's not a representation from any authorities or whatsoever.
Okay, so there's four things that you need to know about this PLH, okay? Number one being the 10 years MOP instead of 5 years. So bro, how does it affect us?
Quick illustration, if let's say you're 25, 26 years old, you buy a HDB or you apply a PLH, okay, with construction time, okay, and everything in, potentially it could take up to 15 years later before you can actually consider, you know, options like renting out the entire unit or selling the unit to upgrade.
So 26 years old plus 15 years is what? 41 years old.
Early 40s already. So the key word here is, how many 10 years do you have?
人生有幾個十年呢?
是啊。
Okay, so the second thing that you need to take note of is actually you cannot rent out the unit even after MOP period. And what does that mean?
You can only rent out rooms only.
Yeah, so meaning to say you cannot rent out the whole unit.
Forever.
Okay, so I think the most challenging one is the third one, which is the more stringent eligibility criteria.
Eligibility is not eligibility.
So what it means is that assuming now you as a owner of the PLH, right, you have already fulfilled your 10 years MOP, then you want to sell your unit. So the buyer who wants to buy your unit, number one, at least one of them has to be a Singapore citizen.
For PLH, to me, this is a little bit not so acceptable lah. You need to fulfill 14,000 income ceiling, macam you buy BTO like that.
Eh, then it means to say your property cannot be sold for more than 1 million already lah.
I never say.
I think so lah. Okay, I think the next one also quite bad lah. That is singles. Singles cannot buy properties in the PLH, right? Oh, 不要說啊。
This PLH model, you cannot own any private property for the past 30 months.
How does that affect us?
So I think the intention, you know, they were saying that they want to be more inclusive lah, but the way I look at it, you are restricting PRs from coming in to buy, okay?
And also the 哥哥姐姐 also cannot buy.
哥哥姐姐们就会比较难买
Okay, so the last thing you need to take note of is the subsidy recovery. So what it means is that when you sell your property, right, the government will actually take back a portion of your sales proceeds. That's what it means. Okay, but how does it affect us?
So you look at the big picture. Okay, firstly, you wait for 10 years to be able to sell. Then you have an income ceiling of 14,000 restriction for your buyers on top of whatever eligibility condition that you mentioned earlier. Yeah. This gives you a smaller buyer pool already. Okay. Finally, you found the buyer. The buyer buys. Okay. We calculate all the cash proceeds and so on and so forth. You realize that a portion of it still needs to go back as a form of calling back of the subsidy. This gives you very little cash proceeds at the end of the day. If you want to buy a PLH HDB flat, right, you must be prepared that you are going there. Okay. To stay in a prime area, your desire to stay in a prime area, okay, but the possibility of you upgrading, right, is very, very much restricted. So think about that.
So actually, after hearing from us, right, what are the thoughts you have? If you have anything, or I mean, any questions
at
all,
comment below, yeah.
Remember
to like and share our video.
Thank you.